Good morning, friends, and welcome to episode 92 of Looking at Stamps. And today's theme is books. We had authors last week, and I thought it would be appropriate to celebrate stamps that celebrate books. So the first is the Library of Congress stamp. This is Scott number 3390. This was issued in 2002 on the 200th birthday of the Library of Congress. And the Library of Congress is the oldest federal institution and is also currently the largest repository of knowledge in the world. So that is the Library of Congress stamp 3390. I purchased this stamp simply because of the yellow color. I love this gold mustard yellow color that they've used here. I just think it's a very, very attractive stamp. The next stamp set that we're going to talk about is a fan favorite. Many of you have seen this series of stamps already. This is the Children's Classics stamp set. This is 2785 to 2788. It highlights four children's literature classics, and I'll show those to you individually. First is 2787, and that is The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn by Mark Twain. We then have Little Women by Louisa May Alcott, 2788. We have 2785. This is Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farm by Kate Douglas Wiggins. And by the way, Kate Douglas Wiggins is the first person to establish a kindergarten in the West, and the first one to establish a school for teachers. And finally, we have one of my favorites, and I read every one of the books in this particular series, and this was Laura Ingalls Wilder series, Little House on the Prairie, or the Prairie series. So let me show those to you again. There's Little House on the Prairie, Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farm, Little Women, and The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. The next one is another one of my favorites, one of my childhood favorites. I call this the Bro series. This is Folk Heroes. This was issued in 1996. This is Scott number 3083 to 3086. These were some of my childhood favorites. First, we have 3083. This is Mighty Casey from the poem Casey at the Bat, a baseball hero. He played for the Mudville Nine. It's the bottom of the ninth, two outs. Casey is not up for two more batters. The first batter, and they're down 4-2. The first batter gets a single. Second batter gets a double. And so we have runners on second and third. And Casey at the bat, he lets the first ball go. No swing, strike one. He lets the second ball go. No swing, strike two. He swings at the third bat. At the third ball and misses, he's out, and Mudville Nine loses. He gets his revenge in the poem that follows in Casey's Revenge. Then we have Paul Bunyan, 3084, the hero of Lumberjacks and his adventures of Babe the Blue Ox. And he single-handedly scooped out the Great Lakes and Puget Sound. Then we have John Henry, the hero of the steel drivers, of railroad men. He was working at the Big Bend Tunnel in West Virginia, and he battled a steam drill for 10 hours and won, and then died. And then we have a Texas favorite, Pecos Bill, America's first cowboy, the only cowboy known to be able to rope a railroad train and ride a cyclone. So those are the folk heroes. Scott number 3083 to 3086. We have another one of my favorites. This is the Tom Sawyer from The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, which is the prequel to The Adventures of Huck Finn. This was issued in 1972, and this is the scene where Tom is being is doing penance for being punished for stealing the jam of the morning, and Aunt Polly has made him whitewash the fence, and he convinces all of his friends to do it for him, and in exchange for the knowledge and for the privilege of letting them paint, they all have to give him a token of appreciation. And so by the time it's all over, there are three coats of paint, and he has collected a whole bunch of baubles and gets to go play. So that is Mark Twain's The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. This is 1470, issued in 1972. And the final stamp today is the Nation of Readers stamp. Nation of Readers stamp. This is 2106. This shows Abraham Lincoln reading to his son Tad. And it is believed that Lincoln acquired most of his education through reading, so therefore he was chosen as the image of this particular stamp. And that's all the time we have for today. Have a great day. I'll talk with you tomorrow. Bye-bye.